Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial, and today I will show you how to create a new method in Android Studio inside the Java, that is MainActivity. So let's go to the Android Studio, and we have nothing to do with the activity underscore main.xml. So let's move on to the MainActivity.java, and we already have discussed about the basic structure of the MainActivity. We have the package name, import, and a public class. So today we are going to learn about how to create a new method inside the MainActivity public class. So you can see, before creating a method, we have to learn about some of the things that you should to create a new method. So first of all, a method require a access specifier. So you can see here, it is public class MainActivity, which is actually a kind of parent method. So here you can see public, then it's class, then MainActivity. So the public is going to be the access specifier. So there are three different kind of access specifiers in Java. One is public, the second one is private, and the third one is protected. So the public is going to be available for many other activities, not only for the MainActivity. Anything that you have written inside the public is going to be available to all other activities. And if you declare the access specifier as private, then the method is only going to be available inside that particular class. And if you declare the access specifier as protected, then that method will be going to available inside that class, but it's not going to be available outside that class. For now, let's go and create a new method. So here is another method created with the name onCreate. Now, if you want to create a method, you have to declare it under the MainActivity, which is going to be the parent class. So we have to type the new method here. So first, you have to give the access specifier. I'm going to give it as private. And the second thing is going to be void, because it returned nothing. So we have to use the void, which actually means empty or null. And after the void, we have to declare the name for the method, which is going to be same as what we have done in case of the variable. I just want to name the method as my application. Okay, you can give anything as you want, it doesn't matter, just like the variable, or we can simply give it as get something. Okay, so this is not going to be a keyword or something like that. You can give it as any name. And after that, we have to open the brackets, then we have to add the curly braces, and inside that you can type anything and call this special method from outside this method. For example, I just want to show a toast when this get something method is called. So I'm typing a toast, and we are going to show a message that is okay. So here you can see I have created a method that is get something, and when the user call this method get something, it will show a toast with this message. So now we have the basic structure of creating a method. Now let's go and call this from somewhere else. So I'm going to MainActivity, and in order to call this method, we need something else, or we can directly call the method when the application is just opened. So if you want to call this method when the application is just opened, then you can add something under the set content view. So the onCreate is going to be called when the app is started. So I just want to call the get something over here. So just type get something. Okay, now you can see I have called this from the onCreate method. So what happened when we are running this on a live device is that there will be a toast with the same message as we have typed it over here. So if you want, you can also give it from the button, and inside the one click listener, you can give the get something. Likewise, you can create as many as methods you want. So the reason why we are creating a method is just to decrease the complication inside the programming. So you can probably just call each items as many as times you want without creating the toast again and again and again. You can simply call this method and make the things work, and you can also reduce the number of lines you're writing in programming through creating a specific method for that. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this tutorial, and if you like this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, then do it now. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next tutorial.